Hello friends, here in this video we will see what is meant by bolts of uniform strength. I'll write the topic name: bolts of uniform strength. As per the name, when we are having the bolts, they should be of uniform strength. To explain this, here I'll draw a diagram. This is the diagram of bolt, of a simple bolt which I'm drawing. This is the bolt head. Now, as we can see in the diagram of this bolt, here we have a threaded section, and then this section is plain, it doesn't have threads. Now, this portion which do not have threads, it is called as shank. After the shank, here we have the threaded section. When the load is acting over this bolt would be failing at a minimum area, or we can say where the area is not uniform. If we look at the shank, the diameter of the shank is uniform. But if we look at the threaded portion, here we are having uneven area. So it is very much clear that failure will start in this threaded section. This bolt will not fail at the shank, it will fail at the threads. And by failing, we mean that the threads, they are going to break. Now, looking into this diagram, since I can say that stress will be maximum where area is minimum. Now, if we compare here, this is the minimum diameter, which we call it as the core diameter, D suffix C, and then we have the outer diameter called as the nominal diameter, DO. So what will happen is that when the load is acting over this bolt, the threaded section stresses will accumulate in this section. And because of this, when the load is applied at the core diameter, as we can see, the diameter is less, so even area is less. So when we apply a load, there are chances of breaking of threads at the core. The threads will break at the core like this. Now, if we look into the diagram, the diameter of the shank is equal to the outer diameter of the threads, that is the nominal diameter, and we are left with DC, which is the minimum diameter. It means the shank has sufficient strength. Similarly, outer diameter is having strength, but DC, it is weaker section. So failure will start at this weakest section. So here I can say that this much portion, the threaded section, it is the weakest section. So if we need to avoid this condition, that is, if we want to avoid the breaking of these threads, because what is happening is that in the bolt, half of the part up to the shank, it is a stronger part, whereas the threaded portion, they are weaker. So the load distribution is non-uniform, and even the stress distribution is non-uniform. Threaded section will have more stress compared to the shank, which is the plain portion. So what we have to do, we have to make such a bolt which has uniform strength, that is the strength is same throughout. Now how that can be done? One of the method is to reduce the shank diameter up to the core diameter. I'll draw it and explain. Here I am explaining one of the methods to get bolts of uniform strength. These are the threaded section. Now, here previously the shank diameter was equal to the outer diameter. Now what we are doing, we are removing the material at the shank and making the shank diameter equal to the core diameter, as we can see in this diagram. Now when the load will be acting, load will not concentrate only in the threaded portion, but it would be uniform because the diameter of the shank, the shank diameter is equal to the core diameter, smaller diameter DC. So when you make the shank diameter equal to core diameter, then that would be called as bolt of uniform strength. Under the action of load, this bolt would be equally stressed in the shank and in the threaded portion. So the chances of failure of such a bolt is less as compared to the previous one, where the core diameter was less and shank diameter was equal to the nominal diameter. Now one more method to get bolts of uniform strength is that in this same diagram, suppose if we are not making the shank diameter equal to the core diameter, the other method is to drill a hole inside the shank passing through the bolt head like this. See, this is one more method, like where we are drilling a hole. This is the drilled hole. So another method of getting bolts of uniform strength is in the simple bolt, where the shank is equal to the diameter, which is the nominal diameter, we can simply drill a hole. So now what will happen when this is subjected to load, along with the weakest section, even this section where there is hole, stress would be distributed, and in this way the stress would be uniform. So in this video we have seen what are meant by bolts of uniform strength.